Tim, I'm curious because I go. I was just talking to Lori Schmidt about it, and Stan. I go both ways. I understand why you may want to insulate the players from having to answer all the questions. I do feel like at least somebody, Ryan Day, somebody from the university should speak. What was your reaction to the canceling of the media availability tomorrow?
My reaction was disappointed, but expected it. So there you go. I think I stumped it up.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. I mean, and I'm not defending them by any stretch. I mean, defending it by any stretch, but I understand it. You know what I mean?
I'm
test some understanding.
I'm kind of that way too, Tim.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And bottom line is, Ryan Day has only been a head coach for like, 22 hours now.
Yeah.
23 hours maybe. And number two, the players, we all want to ask a million questions, just like we asked a million questions in Chicago when he fired Zach Smith the day before, and we finally got Urban, and then we got some of the players. But I understand, being a human being, I understand why they're doing it. But yes, the more interviews I can get, the better. I remember there was a guy one time that lamented while Robert Smith was a player at Ohio State. He said he talks too much. I go, and this guy was in the media. I go, what are you talking about?
Yeah.
But there's a lot going on, a lot for these guys to answer about. And until they have all the answers, maybe it's sort of like, futile exercise.
Well, I think they're trying to control the narrative. Hey, look, if anybody understands shutting down the media, I understand. I do it in 97. I personally start talking. But talking about Ryan Day, I mean, I was a little shocked.
Yeah, but wait a minute. You had one of the great quotes of all time. You were talking about something one day. I was asking you about how you felt after that game. You said you got beat. You felt like you got beat up by a sock full of nickels. That was one of the great lines I've ever. I had never heard that line before.
That must have been the Florida
Stan,
State
when you
game.
Did talk people, when you did talk people, not only listened, they took notes.
Yes, that's right.
So let's talk about Coach Day, because I was a little surprised that he was the guy that they tapped, knowing that you've got two former head coaches on this staff. Is it your opinion, like most, that the reason they didn't go with Schiano or Wilson is because of their history?
One of my favorite things about Twitter is you put something on there and you just put sort of like interesting, as I tweeted yesterday when that came out, interesting that they went with Brian Day instead of Schiano and Kevin Wilson. And then people, proceeded to tell me, how stupid I was of saying it was interesting. One guy said I actually said confusing when I didn't. Bottom line was, I was just throwing it out there because we all know that Greg Schiano was in line to get the University of Tennessee job, probably had an offer in hand and had it rescinded when a Twitter firestorm developed over whether he should have done more or whether he did anything while he was an assistant at Penn State to stop the Jerry Sandusky situation and whether how much he knew about it. And then, of course, Kevin Wilson, left Indiana, basically, more of a mutual parting because there were some allegations over there that he was a little hard on guys who were had injuries or, had some ailments and things like that. There was really only – it seemed to be only one real person pushing that agenda from a post-player standpoint. But, obviously they'd have to be answering questions about that. So it wasn't that big a surprise, except Ohio State did not only stood by Greg Schiano last year when he had his debacle with Tennessee, but gave him a substantial raise to $1.5 million a year. So, yeah, I mean, based on him and his title, I probably expected Schiano to be named the guy. But I understand there is a – definite, but even before this, Urban Meyer has a definite definite admiration for what Ryan Day brings to the table, and as we all know, he fought hard to keep him in the fold. And when Tennessee came calling for him to be their offensive coordinator under Mike Vrabel in January, and of course he's now making $1 million a year, and for the first time in his life, he is a head coach. He is a head coach, if it's only temporary. visiting, or maybe not. Who knows where this is going?
Right, exactly. Visiting with Tim May of the Dispatch about the ongoing situation with Urban Meyer in Ohio State. Meyer, of course, on administrative leave, the university doing an investigation. And Tim, we were just talking the last segment before the break, before we came to you. I just want your perspective on this. It strikes me, and I mentioned this morning on the air on WTVN, that if there's an investigation to clear Urban Meyer or prove that he didn't know or whatever to keep him as head coach, it seems to me that this can't be something that like is resolved in a week, can it? It seems to me you're going to have to go through a lot of records because you don't want another landmine to blow up in your face where you, yeah, we believe Urban Meyer and you put him as head coach and then all of a sudden something else comes up. What is your perspective? Do you think that this is going to be a long haul if Urban Meyer is retained as head coach in this?
Matt, after that long question, I'll have you a succinct answer. I really don't know because, like you pointed out, how thorough are they going to be? Really, what, in fact, are they even seeking in the investigation? You know, are they just – Is the linchpin, as I've said on a couple of these kind of interviews through the day, because I've done a million of them today with stations around the country. But, I mean, is the real question whether Shelley, his wife, told him about her communications with Courtney Smith? Is that the answer? It seemed like that would be a quick answer, you know, to that, because then who's going to debate that one way or the other and have any reason to have a question about it, her answer. So it evidently goes past that. As I pointed out yesterday, that when this went from like, okay, you know, we've asked Urban about this, we've checked on it, he's still the head coach, or he's the guy, he's, you know, they went, instead of doing that or instead of firing him, they went to the purgatory area, which is administrative leave with pay, meaning, you know, he's still under their aegis, is that the right word? Probably not. Under their
if you say it's the right word, it is, yeah.
Yeah, but under their purview, he's still under their purview while they conduct an investigation, and then, since he's being paid, obviously, he's beholden to them to answer questions, et cetera. But now, I went from a succinct answer to an answer as long as your question.
I know.
Because I really, at this moment, I really don't know. You know, obviously, we didn't get to talk to any of the higher-ups yesterday who matter in this, you know, starting with Gene Smith. Obviously, this goes above athletics when you're talking about not only this kind of question of your head football coach, but the question that's involved. And, you know, and the other question that I'm not clear on, and maybe just because I don't quite understand it, is whether this would, in fact, rise to a Title IX violation if, in fact, it's found that he did know about it. Because, you know, Courtney Smith is not a student or an employee of Ohio State. This didn't happen at an Ohio State event or on Ohio
campus.
State premises.
Yep.
Yeah, and so I don't even know where that goes. Obviously, Jack Smith was an Ohio State employee when, for example, the 2015 event that we're all talking about came down. But, you know, as you know and I know, you were in Chicago when we were all running around. You know, we were trying to get finally, you and I was on y'all's show when it came out that the Powell police had finally found report from 2015, which we couldn't find all day on Monday and all day on Tuesday until about 4 in the afternoon. And, of course, Urban Meyer and his group couldn't find it either. And so, you know, the way he steadfastly or just matter-of-factly said he knew nothing of that, you know, I've been around the guy for a long time, just like you have, and boy, he seemed very sure of himself when he said that.
So, Tim, real quick, you've been around here a long time. This question is more of a big picture. I know it's not the most important thing, but if Urban Meyer were to be let go as head coach, how attractive is this job when you think of, I think the last coach is Paul Brown, who was able to leave under his own circumstances. All our greatest coaches have been terminated.
Yeah, but almost all of them, it was self-inflicted, you know, for one way or another that got them that way. You know, I mean, John Cooper, you know, maybe the closest to just being fired because, you know.
Yeah.
But everybody else had something going on, you know, and, you know, maybe not Earl Bruce either, because Earl Bruce had a tough season in 87. And, you know, we all know that he had some problems with the administration, and I guess vice versa. But yeah, I mean, it's, you know, Woody Hayes went out swinging, as the old saying goes. Before him, you know, I forgot his name, was a player here and everything else, but he just pretty much walked away because he didn't like the pressure anymore. But the bottom line is, yeah, it's a tough job, but a lot of times, as your former coach, John Cooper used to say, it doesn't catch up with you until it catches up with you, you know, and that, that doesn't make any sense, and it makes all kinds of sense, kind of like a Yogi Berra-ism. But, you know, we'll see where this goes. I'm sitting here, though, sort of amazed, stunned may not be the right word anymore, but amazed that we're sitting here talking about this at this moment because, wow, you know, I didn't see this 4 weeks ago.
I know. Tim, ordinarily you'd be writing a story about Ohio State being ranked third in the preseason coaches poll, and that's so insignificant with everything else that's going on. It's like a blip on the radar. So, anyway.
But you know what? But the season is still coming.
It
is. That's the interesting part about it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. No matter who's coaching. Tim, thanks so much. Appreciate you taking a few minutes for your perspective.
Man, I always enjoy it. You know that.